Hey, it's Allison from Computers.Mom, and today's video is all about Apple's Password Manager. It's incredibly helpful and easy to use once you know how. Before we dive in, should you use a password manager? Security experts say yes, because it can help you keep track of your passwords safely and accurately, save time and frustration, makes it easier to use good, strong passwords, and even helps you avoid some scam websites. There are lots of password managers available, but if you use any Apple devices, you already have one. Macs and iPhones and iPads include a free and powerful password manager that is turned on by default, meaning that it can automatically save and fill in passwords for you and sync them among all your Apple devices. While there's no such thing as perfect security, Apple uses robust protection to keep your passwords safe. You can see, search, edit, or delete those passwords whenever you want on any of your Apple devices. And Apple will even monitor your passwords for security problems. However, no password manager is perfect, so we'll look at some of the quirks you may encounter too. What's stopping most people from using a password manager is the learning curve to get started, so this video is designed to make it easy for you. We'll cover getting started with the password manager, saving passwords, using saved passwords, seeing and editing your passwords, and cleaning up your passwords list. Don't worry about taking notes, you'll find a recap of the steps at the end of the video. I'm going to demonstrate on a Mac, and most of what we'll cover is the same on the iPhone or iPad, but where there are differences, I'll point them out as we go along. Apple has had a password management system called Keychain for decades, but in the fall of 2024, they moved its functions to a separate app called Passwords, with this colorful keys icon, which was then updated to this new design in 2025. There are just a few requirements to make it work. You'll need updated software on a Mac, macOS 15 Sequoia or later, on an iPhone or iPad, iOS 18 or iPadOS 18 or later. If you're not sure, you can find your software version on any device in Settings, General, About, and here it is. You'll also need to be signed into your Apple account and have iCloud Password Sync turned on. Select your name at the top of the settings menu to be sure you're signed in. Select iCloud and then Passwords. Make sure that Sync is turned on. This syncs your passwords to your Apple account in the cloud so that they're safe. If you enable Sync on all of your Apple devices, you'll be able to access your passwords whenever and wherever you need them. Note that you need to be signed into the same Apple account on each device for this to work. Thirdly, you will need to use Safari rather than another browser like Chrome or Edge. While it's possible to use a different browser, it's harder, so for this video, we'll stick to Safari. Now let's verify a few settings to make sure that everything will work properly. In Settings, select General and then Autofill and Passwords. Autofill should be enabled, and both Autofill From and set up codes in should be set to passwords. It's also helpful to turn on delete after use so that old verification codes are removed once you've used them. Once the setup is done, the password manager begins working automatically. So how do we save passwords? When you go to a website in Safari, like Instagram, for example, and register for a new account, you need to create a password for that account. Ideally, every password should be unique, long, and use a combination of upper and lowercase letters, numbers, and symbols. It can be a pain coming up with new passwords, so people tend to reuse them or use short, easy ones, which is dangerous. When your cursor is in the password field, the password manager pops up with the suggestion to use a strong password. If you click there to accept it, the password manager creates and fills in a good strong password and automatically saves it for you. You don't have to use their suggestion, though. Click the key symbol to see other options, like a less complicated password without special characters, or just ignore the suggestions completely and type your own. Notice that if we change a password that has already been saved, you will see a prompt to update the saved password. Let's click that to keep our password list correct and current. Now that our password is saved, let's log out and see how to use it. Whenever you return to a site that is saved in the password manager and you want to log in, just click in any login field and the login will pop up with the passwords icon. Here's the step that I find confuses people the most. The password manager is locked for safety, So we have to unlock it first using whatever method you normally use to unlock this device. In this case, it's Touch ID, so I just place my finger on the sensor, the password manager unlocks, and the username and password are automatically filled in. No hunting through lists, no typing, nothing to remember. It makes life online so much easier. Like many websites, Instagram puts username and password fields on the same page. Others split it up and make you enter your username on one page and then your password on another, which means you need to unlock the password manager twice. So that was easy, right? Of course, sometimes Touch ID doesn't recognize your finger. See how it's jiggling when it rejects me? If you try a few times and it doesn't work, it will prompt you to unlock with your password instead, meaning the password you use to log into your computer. On an iPhone or iPad, you might use Face ID or Touch ID or the passcode for that device. But no matter which device you are using, you unlock the password manager the same way you unlock that device. Okay, so we have covered how to save and update and autofill passwords. Next, how do we see or edit them? Since Passwords is now an app, you open it the same way you open any other app. If you don't see it in the dock, you can search for it using apps like this. In the search box at the top, start typing PAS. You don't have to type the whole name. Three letters is usually enough. And then select the Passwords app that has the keys icon. Apps is a new feature in Mac OS 26 Tahoe, so if you haven't updated yet, you can find the Passwords app from Spotlight Search, that's the magnifying glass on the upper right corner of your screen. On an iPad or iPhone, swipe down between the apps on your home screen to open a search box, and once again, type PAS to find the Passwords app. When the app opens, you need to unlock it, as we just saw, using your usual security method. And once it's open, if you're using a Mac, you'll see it in the dock. If you're going to use it a lot, you have two options to make it more accessible. See this first skinny vertical bar on the dock? If you drag the Passwords app to the left of that bar, it will stay in the dock so you don't have to hunt for it next time. Also, if you open the settings in the password menu up here, you can check this first box to add the Passwords Manager to the menu bar at the top. That's my favorite because then your passwords list is always available, but it takes very little space on the screen. Now let's look at the app itself. When it's open, we have a navigation pane on the left with a bunch of options, and in the center, we're looking at the list of all our saved passwords in alphabetical order. We can easily scroll through it, but there are a lot of them, so it's usually faster to use the search box at the top here. Just start typing the name of the site, and in most cases, you'll find it very quickly. Suppose you want to see the password for Pinterest. Type the first three letters in the search box, and the list is automatically filtered down to only sites that contain those three letters, like Advantage Shopping, and here's Pinterest. Again, you don't need to type the whole name. If we select Pinterest, the rightmost pane displays the login details for this account. I've been using the term password for convenience. But it would be more accurate to call this a login, because it's not just a password that gets saved, right? Each login consists of three things: the address of the site you were logging into, your username, which is often but not always your email address, and a password. The combination of those three items makes up one unique login. Note also that each login record tells you when it was last saved or updated. The password is hidden by dots, but all you have to do is point to it and it becomes visible. You can copy the username or password just by clicking on them. You can also edit your passwords if needed and add any notes you might want right here. On an iPhone or iPad, tap the dots to make the password visible and at the same time bring up the copy password option. Back on the Mac, note the security warning on this login. Your passwords are monitored for safety, and whenever there's an issue, you'll see a warning on that login so you can take care of it. You can see all of the issues in the security section here. That's a whole topic of its own, but for now, suffice it to say that while you do want to pay attention to these notifications, you shouldn't panic if you see a large number here. That's very common and usually not as bad as it looks. Say we're done with Pinterest and we want to go back to the complete password list. We're not seeing all of the passwords because we still have PIN in the search box. To see the whole list again, just click the X to clear the last search. I mentioned earlier that the password manager is not perfect. It's completely normal to find that it's full of outdated, duplicate, missing, or just plain wrong information. One of the most common issues is having multiple logins saved for the same site. For example, Citibank is here 5 separate times with different usernames. How did this happen and what should you do about it? This first one is my husband's username. He must have used my computer at some point and it got saved. Number 2 has the username in all caps, and number 3, it's lowercase. Those are treated as different logins, even though they will probably both work. Most websites are case sensitive for the password, but not the username. Number 4 got saved because the website hides the username with stars for privacy reasons. That's not the correct username. And this last one was saved with no username. That's obviously not going to work. In reality, we probably only have 2 separate logins, mine and my husband's, and you might be tempted to delete some of these from the list, but we haven't even looked at the password, so we don't know yet which of these is right. Oh, except the one with no username, that definitely won't work. When you find multiple logins saved like this, the only way to know for sure which ones will work is to try using them on the site. Let's try this on the Staples website. When we go to their login page, you can see a login is available, but there are other logins saved for this site. If we click here, the various options that were on my password list are all visible, so we can test them one at a time, like this. If you find the correct login, you can go delete the incorrect ones in the password manager if you want to. But in this case, none of them is right, so the only option is to reset it and make sure that the login gets saved. Another issue you might run into, missing logins. If you created an account somewhere else, like in Chrome, you may not have that login saved. And even if you use Safari, some sites prevent the login from saving automatically. For example, you won't find your Apple account password saved here unless you add it yourself. To add a missing login manually, just click the plus sign right here, fill in the 3 parts of the login, and save it. Also note that some sites are saved with unexpected names. The most common example of this is Microsoft. If I search for Microsoft, it shows up under a different site name. You see, it doesn't say Microsoft. You just have to know that for whatever reason, Microsoft logins appear in password lists under live.com. So between multiple logins and outdated logins, your password manager can get pretty messy, but that is okay. Don't waste a lot of time worrying about cleaning it up. You have better things to do. Some messiness is normal. The only thing that really matters is making sure that you do have the correct logins for the sites that are important to you. I want to briefly point out a few other features of the Passwords app. It can track passkeys as well as passwords. If you're not familiar with passkeys, they're a newer and safer way to log in that is slowly replacing passwords. Check out the video linked above to learn more. It can also save verification codes for sites that require a second factor and login details for different Wi-Fi networks that you've joined in the past. And if you delete a password, it sticks around for 30 days in the deleted section just in case you made a mistake. Finally, note that you can share passwords with other people. You can set up groups to share specific passwords with family or friends or colleagues, very much like the way you share different photo albums with different people. That's a topic for another video as well. So despite a few quirks, the Apple Passwords app is really a fantastic tool. If your computer dies or your iPhone gets stolen, your passwords remain safe and available on any of your Apple devices. So we've covered the basics of using the Apple Password Manager. Here's a quick recap of the essential steps for convenience. To use the Password Manager on an Apple device, you will need macOS Sequoia 15 or later on a computer, iOS or iPadOS 18 or later on an iPhone or iPad. Make sure you're signed into your Apple account and have iCloud Sync turned on for passwords. You'll find that in Settings, Your Name, iCloud, Passwords. And in Settings, General, Autofill and Passwords, verify that autofill is turned on and using Apple's Passwords app. Passwords will be saved and filled and updated automatically on websites if you are using Safari and in many apps on your iPhone or iPad. To access saved passwords, whenever you use the Passwords app, you unlock with the same security method used by your device, whether that's Touch ID, a password, Face ID, or a passcode. To see or edit passwords, open the Passwords app. You can use Apps or Spotlight or whatever method you prefer. Locate the login by typing a few letters of the site or username. Point to it or tap the password to see and copy it. Understand that the password manager info can get messy, and that's okay. The main point is to have access to the logins you actually need. And finally, keep an eye on the security section. Thanks for watching. Please click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.